Hallelujah. Praise God. Glory to God. Father, we give you glory, honor, and praise in Jesus' name. You know, we are in a season where a lot of reformation is going on. You know, Luke chapter 5, Jesus puts it this way. He said, new wine is poured into new wineskins. And so there needs to be a reformation, a restoration of biblical truths in our biblical paradigms, the way we understand and our theology. And if over the season your theology isn't changing on at least one or two fronts, then you need to be asking the Holy Ghost, will you renew me? You know, Romans 12 says, be renewed in the spirit of your mind. And reformation, it just goes along with restoration, it goes along with revival. And we find that typically apostles and prophets, out of the nature of their calling, are often the first of the mark. And this is why Paul, for instance, in Ephesians 2, he says this in from verse 19, Ephesians 2:19, he says, now therefore, you're no longer strangers and foreigners, but fellow citizens with the saints and members of the household of God, having been built on the foundation of apostles and prophets, Jesus himself being the chief cornerstone, in whom the whole building, being fitly framed together, grows and becomes a dwelling place of God for the Spirit. So, and then in Acts chapter 2, verse 42, it says, they gave themselves to the apostles' doctrine. There's something about the release of reformation, of restoration of truths and doctrine that comes through apostles and prophets. Paul again speaks of this in Ephesians chapter 3, where he says in verse 5, he says, in other ages it wasn't made known to the sons of men, in other words, the mysteries of the gospel, but it has now been revealed by the Spirit, to his holy apostles and prophets. And one of the ways that these revelations come is when the Lord Jesus himself shows up to people and begins to speak a restoration or a tweaking or an adjusting of doctrine that has been widely held by the body of Christ. So what happened was that every week, by instruction of the Lord, I take a 48-hour time of Sabbath and worship and just being with the Lord. And in my most recent time of just being on lockdown with the Lord and fasting from all media and all that, the Lord Jesus appeared to me in a vision. And in the vision, he gave me an invitation. And as I was, obviously I responded positively to the invitation, but he asked me to share this revelation and this invitation with the global body of Christ. And he asked me to do it I'm not gonna be doing it on this broadcast, I'll be doing it I'll tell you when in just a while. But the reason he asked me to do that is because he wants to give people an opportunity to hunger and to desire a closer walk with him. And one of the things that's gonna happen on the day that I share the revelation, he said he's also going to, hallelujah, he's gonna appear also, he's gonna, you know, reveal himself to several that will be watching. So the day that I'll be sharing this is on the Lord's Day, this coming Sunday, the 9th of August, Sunday the 9th of August, not this Sunday, the one after, depending on when you're watching it, but Sunday the 9th of August, between 3 and 4 p.m. British summer time. So I want you to tune in on, either on Facebook, it'll be on Facebook Live, later I'll upload it to YouTube. Now, the platform from which it will go will be the Zoom platform. So the Zoom platform login will be given to all members of the Apostolic Family Coalition that I lead, the Interprophetic Apostolic Alliance, also the Nigeria Academy of Prophetic and Apostolic Reform in Nigeria. I'll give them all the login details. Now, if you're not known personally to us and you'd like to be part of the Zoom platform, then just drop us a line to tell us one or two things about yourself. And if there's enough spaces, then we'll gladly let you have the login. Now, this invitation from the Lord, it won't cost you anything, but I just want to say a few things about it. It will greatly deepen your walk with him. It will transform your prayer life. It will bring health and healing to your physical body. It will bring a new level of structure and order to your daily life. It will lengthen your days on earth. It will bring a renewed sense of the holy presence of the Lord to your home and wherever you go. It'll also purge your life. It'll keep you pure and undefiled. It will cause honor to increase in your life. It will cause favor to be multiplied. It will fill you with a sense of daily joy and expectation, and hallelujah, it will lead to the salvation of many in your family and many of your associates and close friends also. So it's an invitation, again, that the Lord Jesus showed me in a vision when he appeared, and it will adjust our understanding of biblical biblical paradigm. So why don't you make it a date, let your friends know, and join me on Sunday the 9th of August between 3 and 4 o'clock, when I'll be sharing it. God bless you. Father, I thank you so much for your people. I thank you for all that you're going to reveal on that day. And I thank you. I'm excited because I know, Lord, that many are going to have visions of you too, in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. See you. Look forward to seeing you there. Bye.